What is up, everyone? Conixis here, and welcome back to episode 4 Golden. I know it's been like 90 years, right? Yeah, we're finally back on episode 4 Golden. Just wanted to get Sunrider out the way. Now that we're finally caught up with Sunrider, back to talking to Nanako.
The boys at school pretend they're in gangs when they run around.
Oh, don't associate with them, Nanako. You gotta be a good girl. You should return to your room, rest early. You gotta get ready for tomorrow. Well, what the fuck is tomorrow? You should rest and get ready for tomorrow. Oh yeah, I forgot. We're gonna go on the stakeout tomorrow, aren't we? Completely forgot about that. Yes, we're back. It's the gang. It's a random guy.
Has the target arrived at school?
I don't know.
Yes, ma'am. Visual ID confirmed.
Oh.
Target arrived in zone near the end of his mess break, with mother-issued rations in hand. Current status, in the bathroom, fixing his hair.
Dough.
The target was acting nervous. I left my position before he had a chance to pick on me.
I wonder what kind of plans they made. It didn't seem like he knew that boy very well.
Yeah.
Well, I think there's something more subtle.
Oh, he's here!
Oh boy! It's Conji. I've always wondered, how the hell does his jacket stay like that? Especially with all the commotion he does. Did he, like, sew it to his shirt?
I didn't keep you waiting, I hope.
No, I just got here, too.
Yeah. There they go. Like, they didn't notice us just chilling.
What
at least,
in the
like,
world
Naoto
was that?
Didn't notice. Like, come on now.
Or we'll lose them.
Okay, then let's split up into two groups. One team will follow Conji, and the other will stake out the shop.
Yeah.
Roger that. How should we split the teams?
I'll go with Chie, because, you know.
I wouldn't mind going with you, but you'd leave Yukiko with Yosuke?
No.
That worries me. For other reasons.
Yosuke can't be trusted.
Man, they're almost out of sight. Come on, Yosuke!
So I'm pairing up with Chie? Okay. Alright. We'll need to pretend we're on a date to make it look natural.
No.
Not in a million years.
Damn.
There'll be no need for that if we stay out of sight.
That is true.
Sheesh. Let's hurry up and go!
Yes. I mean, you could also just pretend you're just walking and talking.
I wonder if those two will be alright.
Nah, I think they're gonna blow up the world. Well, nice knowing them.
Oh, that leaves us in charge of staking out the textile shop.
That's correct, Yukiko.
So, shall we?
I mean, I was thinking about getting a steak, but sure, why not? Yeah, I guess. I mean, I'm hungry as fuck, but no, fuck it. Oh.
Sorry about the wait. This one's for you.
Oh, I mean, if you bought two for yourself, you know, it'd probably be in that bush. But hey, not saying I'd throw you in there
Everything
or anything.
Everything seems fine at the shop. I hope it stays that way. Do you think the culprit will come?
I have to be a man. No worries, I'll protect you.
Oh, okay. Thanks.
No problem. I am
counting
gentleman.
On you.
Yes. Yukiko is counting on me.
It would be scary if the culprit did show up.
Yeah, that'd be creepy.
But if they do, I'll do what I can to help you catch them.
Thank you.
You all saved my life. I don't want to be the only one doing nothing.
Don't worry, we got Yosuke for that.
I mean, I'm sure there's something I can do.
Oh, I can think of a few things. You see, I have this itch on my back, and I was wondering if you could scratch it. That'd be so nice, anyways.
Oh, sorry. I went on and on without realizing. I guess I'm a little nervous.
It's all right. I think I'm mute anyways.
I've never chatted with a boy my age like this before.
Oh.
Chie, of course, has no problem getting along with guys because of her personality.
Yeah, she's an interesting one.
But I think she's had more fun hanging out with you and Yosuke lately.
Well, no, not Yosuke, but me, because, you know, fuck Yosuke. He's shit. Anyways.
The same is true for me.
Yay, I'm entertaining for you, Yukiko, even though I'm fucking mute. You sense Yukiko's gratitude and affection.
It's a floating card again!
The priestess of Catas!
Thou art I, and I am thou that has established a new bond. It brings thee closer to the truth. Thou shalt be blessed when creating personas of the priestess Arcana.
Yay! More power! You have established the Yukiko Amagi social link of the priestess Arcana. You may earn experience bonus from fusing personas of the priestess Arcana. Oh, baby! Yukiko's determination and battle has been enhanced! Yukiko can now wake up a knockdown ally during battle. Yay! Usefulness. You haven't yet asked Yukiko for her contact information. Ask her straight out. Give me them digits, Yuki.
Huh? Okay, if you want.
That's what I'm talking about.
I know his answer since I help out around the inn. Feel free to call any time.
Well. God damn it. You exchange cell numbers with Yukiko. There seems to be no change over at the shop. You spoke with Yukiko about many different things. Can we speak to her about why the fuck I'm always recording at like 2 or 3 in the morning? Yeah, it's like fucking 3. God damn it. I'm tired. But it's been a minute, so I gotta play. Oh.
Man,
that's a suggestive position.
Weird.
Yeah, we gotta play more persona. Out.
Yeah, especially like that.
No, I mean them. I get this weird feeling about them.
Oh.
Weird? What about them's weird?
Everything.
I don't know how to put it. Maybe it's just my imagination.
They're gonna go do butt stuff.
Hey, how do you think the others are doing?
I got some digits, so you know, I think my job is done.
Beats me. For all we know, he's hitting on Yukiko as we speak.
You're not far off.
Yeah, no. He's not like you.
See? I can be a player, and Yosuke is already judged before... Oh my god, my train of thought just went off the road there. What I was going to say is, I could go be a player, and everyone will think I'm innocent.
Yukiko doesn't seem to be interested in that stuff anyway.
Oh. Not when I'm done with her.
Wait. Are you saying he's interested in her?
I'm interested in a lot of things. I'm interested in rocks. I'm interested in the sky. I'm interested in that little skirt you got on there. Yukiko is not one of those things.
Well, I wouldn't know.
Oh, he's lying.
We don't really talk about that kind of stuff.
That's the bullshit, Yosuke. Nah, but Yukiko's a good girl. Like, she's all cool and stuff.
Don't you?
It just seems like she's, like, you know, an obvious pick. It just seems like she's, like, the Mary Sue pick, because, you know, the type of shy, weird girl. Well, I don't know. Who do you think is Yu's canon pick? Like, that's something I'm wondering. With Golden out, I'd say Marie, because of how their relationship, like, advances. But with regular Persona 4... I'm not sure. It'd probably either be Chie or Yukiko. I can't tell. I don't know. Who's your canon pick for you?
I seriously don't know. It's not like we've been hanging out that long.
We've been hanging out for like a month and a half or something along those lines. The fuck you talk about, Yosuke?
The hell are you two doing?
I mean, they're literally just talking to each other and you just came up to them, so you're the one in the wrong here, Kanji.
Oh, well... You see, we're just two crazy lovebirds.
I mean, literally, those two were just talking to each other, so technically, Kanji just came out of nowhere and butted into their conversation. You know what I'm saying?
What do you mean, bird?
Play along, bird brain. Didn't I see you guys yesterday?
Maybe.
Come on. It just so happened that we were walking behind you guys. Pure coincidence. Hey, our houses are just over that way, so we'll be going now.
Look, we weren't planning on getting in you guys' way, and there's nothing strange about it either.
Strange?
Strange? Oh, boy.
Why can't you keep your big mouth shut?
Whoa,
wait. Damn it! This ain't what you think. You got it all wrong. Hey, are you listening, damn it?
Kinda.
It seriously ain't like that!
I have a question. This is off fucking topic, but is damn it spelled D-A-M-M-I-T or D-A-M-N-I-T? Or N-M. Fucking hell, I'm tired, but you know what I'm talking about, because I see it spelled so many different ways. What the fuck one is right? Or are they both right? I don't fucking know. It just came to mind.
We regret to inform that our mission failed.
All you had to do was play it off like you were talking.
There was nowhere to hide.
You didn't have to hide. You could have just kept talking like nothing was happening.
Well, let's wait here a little longer. Maybe Kanji-kun will come home.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is.
Huh? What are you guys doing here?
I mean, technically, yeah, you're there in front of his house, so he technically has a point to ask, but you know. They were kind of standing
those
there.
Those stupid lovebirds I just saw.
We're not a couple.
Oh, God.
Why are you assholes following me around?
Damn it, what the hell's going on?
I ain't saying this is you guys' fault, but damn it.
Hey, mind if we ask something? Has anything strange happened to you lately?
Huh? Strange? What's this strange stuff, huh?
Duh.
Are you saying that I'm strange?
No, I mean, did you clearly hear he had said, had anything strange happened to you? He didn't say
no,
you were.
No, I didn't mean...
You shitheads better get the hell out of my face, or I'm taking you down!
I like when his voice gets high. It just sounds so fucking hilarious.
Wait, why?
I look like I'm joking!
Damn it. Fucking hell, Yosuke. You had one job. Run away. You run into a fucking door. And it's his house, too, so you know. That's the smart thing. You ran away from Kanji as fast as your legs would carry you. Oh, baby.
Too much running.
I know that feel. I'm too fat for this shit.
Well, nothing happened today, so I guess everything's okay.
Yeah.
But it's already been a few days since he appeared on the Midnight Channel.
Yeah.
If this is anything like Yukiko's case, it'll happen soon.
Most likely.
Then we can't let our guard down. I think we should come back tomorrow to check up on him.
Yeah.
Looks like we got no choice. Let's go home. I'm wiped.
Let's go. Oh, boy. I'm home.
Welcome home, big bro.
Hello, Nanakyo. It's raining. Yeah, it started raining. I hope you didn't get wet out there. Oh, I think I did. I don't have an umbrella. Oh, I guess, yeah, we got that. Nanako, you gotta say different things and make it interesting. Nothing catches up, of course. Two upstairs. We gotta check on the Midnight Channel. Because it's raining. Let's take a... Oh. Where is it?
Hello?
Hi, Yukiko.
It's Yukiko. I'm sorry to call so late.
You're awfully dressed for late. Like, are you going out partying? What's going on? You didn't invite me, Yukiko. I am hurt. Anyways.
Kanji-kun seems to be missing.
Oh, shit.
I had some calls to make for the inn, so I called the textile shop as well. When I spoke to Kanji-kun's mother, she told me that he'd left the house and hasn't returned since.
Oh, no.
She did say that this happens all the time, but... What do you think?
I think he's just at that age. He should be fine. This sounds bad. This sounds bad!
I think so, too. He could be...
He could be inside the TV!
It's going to rain again tonight. Maybe the Midnight Channel will come on.
It's already raining, Yukiko. I hear it in the background.
We'll know for sure if something happened to Kanji-kun or not.
Well, yeah, that's true.
I'll make sure to check out the TV at midnight. Talk to you later.
Talk to you later.
I love you.
Damn it. Anyways... Well, why do I have my phone? I mean, I'm in, like, my pajamas. Well, motherfucker, go put your phone on the table. You need to watch the Midnight Channel. But I don't wanna. I'm too lazy. Still raining. Oh, it... oh, God! Oh, that was perfect. I didn't even know it would do that. But yeah, it's still raining. I was just being my dumbass self saying it, and it just actually said it. Something may appear on the TV. Oh, God. I am a psychic. TV! What's going on? You see something on the screen. The image is clear and sharp. Oh.
Hello, dear viewers.
Oh, no.
It's time for Bad Bathhouse.
Oh, no.
Tonight I'll introduce a superb sight for those searching for sublime love that surpasses the separation of the sexes.
Oh no.
I'm your host, Kanji Tatsumi, serving you this scandalously special sneak-in report.
Please, no.
Goodness gracious, just imagine the things that might happen to me there.
I don't want to.
Well then, let's get this show on the road. Toodaloo!
Please, no. Look at the way he walks. He walks like a fucking gorilla. That was unmistakably Kanji. Yeah. I don't know, Yosuke. Yosuke's too flustered to get his point across. Calm down, Yosuke.
But that was completely over the top!
I agree with you, but why are you all dressed up at night, man? Are you guys going places without me? Without your friends! Anyways.
It really was Kanji.
Yes, it was. I have to fucking wash my eyes out.
Damn it, we guessed right, but he still slipped through our fingers.
Yeah.
Stayed there a little longer.
Yeah. We suck.
In any case, that place that was behind him, what do you think it is?
I don't want to know.
A superb sight for those searching for sublime love? I just don't get it.
I don't either.
Anyways, we better hurry and come up with a plan tomorrow.
I don't think I want to. I think we should just let him go. That place looks scary. Decided to go to bed. Oh boy, it's the 18th on a Wednesday. It's hot, anyways. Yeah, pretty much.
Given the pattern so far, Kanji's already inside the TV.
Yes, Yosuke.
I wonder what the Midnight Channel really is.
It's... I don't think I can explain it. It's too complicated. Your mind will explode from this knowledge.
At first, I thought it was one of those paranormal things. But when I gave it a try, it was real. Turns out it's actually connected to another world.
If there's a rumor going around, that means a bunch of people are watching it.
Yep.
How did the rumor go? If you stare into a turned-off TV on a rainy night...
You'll see... A fapping man.
No one in their right mind would try something that ridiculous, don't you think?
Unless they're
lonely. Someone urged them to.
Well, you
but
did
if
it.
If you actually try, it does work. And not just once. If this rumor spreads and everyone starts watching the Midnight Channel...
Everybody gonna be seeing that sus shit that Kanji was doing.
It could cause a huge panic.
Yee.
If Teddy is right, the missing people themselves create the stuff we see.
Oh, I forgot about Teddy. Yeah, he is a thing, isn't he?
So it's not random. It's specifically related to whoever goes missing.
Yes, that's correct.
Yukiko had a show too, but she doesn't remember doing anything like that.
Yep.
This might be a little off subject, but...
But...
The culprit is probably watching the shows that come on, right?
Probably, yeah.
No doubt. He's probably sitting back and enjoying... Oh, wait a sec. I bet he is enjoying it.
Yeah, why do you think he's doing it?
He's probably laughing his head off watching the show that comes on after he throws people into the TV.
Most likely. It's his...
Oh, I get it.
What do you
yeah,
call that thing?
Yeah, it's definitely possible.
What do you call that thing? Sick pleasure or something? I don't fucking know.
Now when I think of the
guilty
killer,
pleasure,
I get this
that's
image
it.
Of a total sicko.
I don't fucking know.
I want to see everything about you, Yuki-chan.
I do too. Can you? Never mind.
Wait. So if people saw Yukiko's show, do you think people were watching what happened to me too?
I don't think. I don't know if it works like that.
Oh, that is it! That killer is dead meat! I'm gonna leave footprints all over his face!
Jesus.
Guys!
Yeah?
First we save Kanji, then we crush the killer! Finally, we crush the killer and send him to hell! Huh. Got it?
Okay, sure. You all strengthened your resolve to save Kanji. Ah! Rank up! Yay! Investigation team, social link has reached level 3. Your power to create personas of the floor kind of has grown. Anyway. Oh boy.
GA! Those last two were the same thing! I know.
To the territory! Oh boy! And here comes the most. Whoa! The stupidest thing in the whole game! Oh boy! This part is just amazing! And we have to do it again! And again!
Oh, yep. I think someone's here.
What's good, son?
You think? Do you know where he is?
I don't know.
We think it's a boy named Kanji.
I don't know.
What's wrong? Not feeling well?
Well, I sniff and I sniff, but I still can't tell where the smell comes from.
Aren't you thinking too much about too many things?
Most likely.
I mean, last time you were wondering about who you really are and how long you've been here.
Yeah.
Your head's empty to begin with, dude.
That's true.
Don't stress out over stuff too much.
Yeah, it's too much. Well, you don't have a brain, so I don't know. It's just too much for you.
You're right.
Oh. It's got depressing.
Whoa. He's seriously down about this.
Yeah.
If you can't figure out where Kanji is, we're in deep trouble.
Well, I guess.
You can't just wander around aimlessly in a place like this.
Yeah, sure.
I know what might help. You should give me a clue about this Kanji person.
Boy, here it comes.
It's just a feeling I have. I think I could concentrate better with it. Do you have anything that could give me a good understanding of him?
Something about Kanji, huh? I can't really think of anything besides all the rumors about him.
Yeah, it's not like we know him that well.
Honestly.
I just need some sort of hint. Something that tells me what he's really like.
Yeah, I know.
Why don't we ask around and find people who know Kanji-kun personally?
I guess. Teddy may be able to grasp Kanji's location if he gets more information about Kanji. That doesn't make any fucking sense. But what kind of information does he need? I don't fucking know. You decide to ask around town about Kanji. Most stupid thing in the game. How the fuck does this... Never mind. Anyways, let's go fucking... I gotta go buy Yukiko shit. Because I never did that, I think. So let's go and do that. Well, yeah, like, I hate this part, because it's so stupid. Like, why do we have to do this? Why do we have to do this?
Well, he's a freshman at our school. His family runs a textile shop. He was on TV.
We don't know Jack.
Gee, that's too bad. I guess you'll have to wander around town asking NPCs for vague hints we already knew.
Okay, now that everything's all good and dandy, let's go. Oh, boy. Asking around town about Kanji. Isn't that exciting? Oh boy. Let's see. There's Josuke. There's his mom. Let's talk to her. Kanji's mother is standing in front of the store. You decide to ask her about Kanji. Oh, I thought I was talking to her.
Ah, are you here to ask about Kanji too? Sheesh, I wonder where he has wandered off to now. He's always like this. You know, there was a small boy who came in asking about him not too long ago. I talked to him too, but I haven't seen him around lately.
The boy who talked to Kanji could have been the small boy from before.
If it was him, then he's a Kanji.
No, that's just me and my inner thoughts. Inner thoughts are a female. If it was him, and he was with Kanji, he might know something. He decided to search for the boy. Oh, boy. Anyways. Oh, boy. Fuck. Are you looking for a small boy wearing a hat? Ah, yes, I've seen him. He's been hanging around here lately. He even asked me all stuff about that incident. He was just over there a little while ago, but maybe he'll be back tomorrow. You decide to return here tomorrow. Yeah, fucking tomorrow. You gotta wait a whole day to go save this motherfucker. Anyways, if it wasn't for this shit, I guess I'll go to a club. If there's one available, that is. I don't know. Let's go look. Ba-do-do-do-a-do-do-do. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Anyways, hey, huh? No, not Persona. What the fuck am I doing socially? The strength is at level 3. Okay, so yeah. Let's do this. Yo. Hey, Jay. The gym's open today. The other team said they don't need... Oh, yeah, guys, question! Oh, my God, shit, guys, question. Do you want... I mean, I'm going to do it, but do you want a Persona 3 game Let's Play now, like at the same time as Persona 4, or wait until after Persona 4? I don't know why it came to mind now of all times, but I just remembered. Just let me know if you would like them both going at the same time, or you want to wait until after Persona 4 is done. So just let me know in the comments below. Anyways, gym's open today. The other team said they don't need it. You're going to practice, right? Yes, blah, bloof, go to practice. Sweet, let's give it our best shot. Yeah, Co, let's do it, man! Ah! Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. You also got me at gym. You attend a basketball practice. Huh? The others already left. This is exactly why this team is... Whatever. Hey, good news. You're getting a new, team manager. I don't know what that was. Now you guys won't have to take turns doing all the work anymore. You can thank me later. Go on, introduce yourself.
I, Ebihara.
Oh, hi, forehead. How you doing? Great! You can take it from here. I'm going home. Anyways, I'm gonna tell you guys straight up, I'm not lifting a finger for this team. I wouldn't be caught dead watching out for a bunch of sweaty guys. Huh, then why'd you... I've missed too many days of school, but they'll let me move up if I manage a team. But don't expect me to put any effort into it. For the most part, I'm not even gonna be here.
Goodbye!
Well, see ya, or not. Wow, what a bitch. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah, it's about what I expected when I saw I here. So much for having a manager.
Alright.
Anyways, I'm hungry, let's grab some food. Oh, baby! It's Central Shopping District, Chinese dinner, Aina. Man, this place has been calling to me in my dreams ever since I had to bail on you guys last time. How'd it go? What, the dream? Oh, you mean with my family? Well, it's complicated. Ko was laughing. Daisuke told you all about it, right, Jay? My family's pretty interesting. Arranged marriages for political gain and pretty, standard with us. Just the other day, I was greeting people at one of those high society gatherings. Can you imagine me at one of those things? It's hard to imagine. Seriously, I have to laugh at myself sometimes. Ko smiles wearily. Anyways, if you ever run into anyone in my family, don't tell them I eat here or talk like this. At home, it's nothing but studying, tea ceremonies, and lessons. To them, I'm the prim and proper Ko-sama. Ko-sama? Yep, that's what they call me. I know it sounds crappy, but hey, they feed me and give me an allowance. I need to do my part too, you know? I don't know, man. It doesn't matter. It might all be over soon anyway. Oh? Why is that? We're an old-fashioned family, so the Ichijo name has been passed from generation to generation. But the last male of my family, my dad, didn't have any kids to pass the name on to. Well, they weren't going to let the Ichijo name just up and die, so they adopted me. And then, what do you know, my dad ended up having a kid after all. A girl. I guess you could say she's a little sister to me. Her name's Sachiko. Sachiko, I think. She's almost two, and she's really cute, you know? Ko tries to sound cheerful. That's good for you, Ko. Isn't it? Ko smiles. Dots. It's better this way. Becoming a successor would be a major hassle, and really, it should go to a blood relative. Boop 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 boop. Sorry, didn't mean to put a damper on the mood. Come on, let's eat. Huh. Yeah. Do do do. Your heart-to-heart talk with the player showed you dice game coach trust. Oh boy. Level 4, oh baby! Yes, I know. Just forget I said any of that stuff. Oh man, did I tell you guys about the 1 in a million shot I made? Dots, you talked about practice with Dice Kanko. After saying goodbye, you decided to go home. Hooray. Daisuke, you should wear something else. Wearing the school gym uniform all the time is a little dirty.
Welcome home!
Hi, Nanako. Oh, I could spend a day with Nanako. Oh, man, I'm so happy. I gotta save. I'm so happy. Anyways, I'm safe over that one. I'm so happy. Spend a day with Nanako. Let's go.
Yes?
Nanako looks as if she's not doing anything. We feel a relationship with Nanako. Actually, no, I gotta go get a thing of the Justice Arcana. So let's go to the shopping district. Fuck books. Anyways, go in the fucking velvet room, real. Anyways. Yay! Oh.
Welcome to the Velvet.
Where's Senpai? Senpai's not here. Something's different. Marie's nowhere to be found. Yes, there's a distinct lack of Senpai in this room. I mean, we have Margaret Senpai, but that's only half the Senpai. You need both in order for it to... Anyways, if you're looking for Marie, I sent her on an errand. She should be back soon. An errand? Oh, please don't be concerned. This errand is, of course, pertaining to those of us who reside within the Velvet Room. I would never allow her to roam your world freely by herself. What the fuck? There's a piece of paper on the floor.
Oh.
What is that? She must have dropped it. It seems the piece of paper belongs to Marie. You notice something's written on it. Perhaps you should return it to her.
Huh? Wait, no!
Marie frantically snatches the paper away from you.
What is this?
What are you doing? I mean, what are you doing? Did you look?
Show me, Senpai.
Huh?
Show you? Let's see. Stupid purpose police, well, I hate you! There we go. Why would I show you? This isn't meant for you to see!
Marie is blushing furiously. Baby, just forget this happened! All of it!
I'm hypnotizing you now! Sleep! Sleep! You didn't see anything! Now wake up!
Oh yeah, she did it herself. This is quite an interesting reaction. Is what is on the paper really that embarrassing?
Welcome to the Velvet Room.
Excuse us. Now, once again, welcome to the Velvet Room. Welcome my butt. That was close. Marie returns to her seat and fidgets restlessly. My lord. And so, there we go. Strongest one, I guess. That's why not. There we go. Now you guys can fuck off. I've done all I need to do. There's something else I need to do, actually. No, go in there. She looks like the lady from fucking Monsters, Inc.
I'm gonna give her that voice.
Welcome. I turned my store into a nightclub once normal business hours are over. Have I met you before during the day? Well, that doesn't matter. This is a nocturnal oasis where adults can escape their daily lives and gather in search of a moment of peace.
I think it's like changing, like I can't tell what this voice is.
And I'm a butterfly of the night, adorned with gems who flutters down to bask in this oasis glow. Everything you see and hear here is only a dream, and no, to drag what happens here into the light of day. Remember that. Now, I'm sure you'll understand that this is no place for a child like you. It's time for you to go home. Wait a second. What's that? You seem to have something quite impressive with you. Those beautiful shining stones, of course. Won't you trade them with me?
No thanks. I forgot, I need to- I also forgot! I need to fucking do the fox missions! Forgot all about the fox! I don't think I can accept them at night. I think I can only do it- oh. What the fuck? Hi.
I came to offer my fooda to celebrate my child's 7th birthday. However, I'm so hungry, I can't even walk. It is truly shameful. Do you have any red goldfish you could spare?
No. I do. Fox doesn't seem to be around. It appears that it doesn't come to the shrine at night. Maybe you should pray. No. You run. That lady is going to possibly mug you. Anyways, I need to start doing the fox missions. I forgot all about it, but Nanako! Spend time with
Nanako-chan!
Nanako looks happy.
Big bro.
Nanako is fidgeting. Go ahead and ask.
Yeah. Okay, well.
Nanako looks relieved.
Are you an only child?
That's right.
So you're just like me. Oh, but I have you now, so.
Nanako was smiling cheerfully.
A while ago, Daddy told me that our family won't get any bigger. But now I have a big brother.
Nanako beams at you with a smile that covers her entire face. Nanako is adorable. Through that smile, you feel your relationship has grown deeper.
Yay! Nanako's hand!
Anyways. Nanako Dojima Social Link is reasonable too.
Let's talk, big bro. I want to hear about your school.
Nanako has begged you to talk to her. Okay. You decided to talk about various things. It has gotten late, so you put Nanako to bed and went to your room. Alrighty. Responsible. It's Thursday. Arms back.
Yo.
Hi, Yosuke. According to the weather report, we won't have to worry about the fog for a while. Let's keep cool. Like usual, we can save the day and still keep our skills sharp. That's a good plan. Yeah, it's not going to do anyone any good if we get anxious. Let's be sure to use the time we have until the next foggy day to our advantage so we can save him for sure. Do. Well, since we only usually go an hour, I'm not sure how long it'll take. Okay. I'm not sure how long it'll take for the dungeon, but I guess we can do it in this episode, so next episode we can just do social links and shit, but.
Hey, everyone! They posted the test results!
The awful moment of truth. Oh, wow. Wanna check it out?
sure. You decide to check out the test results. Anyways. You got the highest score! Baby! Whoa, you're a genius, Jay! That's awesome! I'm just as happy as if I'd got the highest score. That's great myself! Oh, Jesus. Your social link friends seem to be looking at you admiringly. Anyways, you feel you can become closer to your school friends. Lunch break is almost over, you decide to return to class. Oh boy. Oh, that's someone wants to hang out too. Oh, hi, what's your me?
Hey, Jay-kun, we have practice today. You'll be there, right?
Will you spend that? No.
I see. Well, it's your choice. But make sure you don't forget what I taught you.
What do you do after school? I don't know. Go home and fucking masturbate? Fucking hell. Anyways. What's up, Dice K? How you doing, man? Hey, you going to practice? Ko looked kind of down, so take care of him. Maybe you should show up to basketball practice after school. No. I don't want to. Things to do. It's after school. Anyways, I gotta go. I gotta do things. I gotta do a couple things, actually. Go to shuffle soccer, blah blah. And I've got to flash. Hi. Catching bugs makes me hungry. I really want a steak skewer, but I spent all my allowance. Oh well, I'll just drink water. I got you, my boy. I got you. Where do I buy those? I don't fucking remember. I'm sorry. I think you buy it here. I wanna buy a steak skewer. Buy it. Thank you very much. And back to the child. Cause, you know, why not buy a random person you just met on the street something to eat? Catching that blah blah blah, oh well, just drink water. You have a steak skewer, do you? Yeah, give him some.
You're giving this to me? Really? My grandpa always says to thank people who give you things. This is to show my thanks.
You received ladybugs. Thanks.
Thank you very much.
Anyways, I gotta go talk to my boy the fox. Anyways, shrine building, what will you do? Accept the Edna's request. You made sure there was no one around and called for the fox. What do I do? Just say, hey, fox, come out. I summon you. The fox has brought you with Emma on the west mountain deep, but the character's probably young girl's handwriting. I want things to go well with the person I like. It seems the fox wants you to fulfill the wish written on the Emma on its behalf. Many be thinking of the wishes fulfilled for our money will be put into the offering box, because this fox probably wants money. Is $20 alright? I wish for love. Yep. The fox seems happy. Cool beans. Now, we must go to the school. I think. Yeah, there we go. Hi.
Ah! What? Oh, you're the transfer student, Jay. Jay? Oh, I must have made a mistake! This is your shoebox!
Female student ran away. Something in your shoebox. It's a note.
Excuse me for writing this to you out of the blue. I held my emotion back all this time because I didn't want to disrupt your studies, but I just had to tell you. I love you!
It's a very moving love note, however, it's actually addressed to someone else. Well, fuck you! You didn't need it anyway, it's not like I was happy or anything. And apparently, the girl put this in the wrong shoebox.
Perhaps she's the one who wrote the Emma request the Fox showed you? Maybe? Coincidence? I don't know. Anyways, you should talk to her the next time you see her. Oh. Hi. How you doing? What do you want? I'm busy. You wanna chill?
What?
Huh? With you? I am staring at you intently. Whatever. You should skip your afternoon classes next time. We'll go somewhere far away. With your overabundant courage, you're able to skip out of class with ease. I'll invite you to come with me when I feel like it. Don't bitch. Anyways, let's go! Yeah, let's like, just go.
To Jonas, to go talk to.
Anyways, is there something you need? Many people from town come and meet here. It's a very convenient location, isn't it? Wasn't this boy who met... Fucking hell. Wasn't this the boy who met with Kanji some time ago? He may know something about Kanji. Slender young man. He's Slenderman. Anyways, you're asking if anything seemed strange when I spoke to Kanji-kun? Yes? Very well. It seems to be an urgent matter, so I'll simply tell you. If you're asking about recent events, then yes, there was something out of the ordinary. It was something I felt when I was with him, so I told him outright that he seemed to be an odd person. After I said that, his expression changed all of a sudden. I was quite surprised. On that basis, I believe his actions were somewhat focused and unnatural throughout the time I was with him. He may have had some sort of complex, though. I have no proof of this. It seems Kanji has a complex or something of that nature. Kanji's purported reaction to the phrase odd person. Maybe this is enough of a clue for Teddy to go... This game's logic. How does... Okay. What the fuck is that? What the fuck is that? There's like things standing up on the map. I don't know what the fuck that is. I don't remember if that's an important thing or that's just a thing. I honestly don't know. But what are we running on? I don't think we can finish the dungeon in 10 fucking minutes. And I mean, I cut things out of the dungeon, so maybe. So let's just go do the fucking dungeon. Let's go fuck shit up. Let's go ram the dungeon right in the poos. Yes. We've got the information, so this is apparently enough. Oh, hi. What are you doing here?
Whoa, something's here.
Yeah.
A fox? When did it...
I don't know. Mysterious fox you encountered at the shrine is sitting next to you. Could it have followed you without you noticing? I believe it.
Whoa, where did this guy come from?
He's mad because I only gave him $50.
This is not okay. This needs to stop now. This is cancer. This is so much cancer that I can feel the tumors growing on my back.
Whoa, did this guy, yeah, goddamn it.
It looks scary.
Fucking
too.
Memes. They distracted me.
Oh, this apron. I think I've seen it at the shrine before.
You told everyone about your encounter with the mysterious fox.
Huh? Curious with leaves?
Yeah, I questioned it too, but I gave him the 20 and, you know.
Huh? Cooperate with us?
Yeah.
Are you serious? So he wants money in exchange for fixing us up?
Well, you know, wouldn't a hospital want money for fixing you up? Wouldn't a doctor want money for fixing you up? Why isn't a fox? The fox gave out a cry as if in affirmation. Anyway,
sorry. What's
with this guy? Why the fuck are you asking me?
It acts like it understands what we're talking about.
Maybe it does. See?
It yipped again. Maybe it really does understand what we're saying.
Yeah.
But when you think about it, that means the police on duty and whatnot didn't find this fox, right?
Yes.
If it followed after us, then it really is something.
Yes. It's me in another life. Fox gave a confident cry.
Huh? You think he really understands us? What should we do? Well, I'd feel bad if we trapped it. It doesn't look like it'll do us any harm.
No, this fox is a fucking con, man. He just wants our money.
What do you think?
Let's chase it away. It can do what it wants. Let's let it help.
Yeah. And thinking about what happened at the shrine, don't you think this curing would be a big help for us?
Yeah.
Huh? Are you suggesting we take it into that other world?
Why not?
I guess that might work. It doesn't seem like it's going to leave that easily either.
Exactly.
And I definitely don't want it being all sulky and getting up to mischief in the store.
Yeah. The fox looks satisfied. He decides to let the fox do whatever it wants. You should try taking it into the other world. Okay. Let's go to the TV.
I'm sure we'll be alright if we work together.
Yes, let's do it. Oh boy. I think we got enough. I don't remember. I'm pretty sure we got the appropriate information. Sensei! You're here! Any clues? Oh, you found some. Let's save. It's good, son.
Oh!
The complex.
That's it? That's all I have to go on? You're working me to the stuffing!
No, my question is, how the fuck do you go on that to begin with? Just because you know what someone's labbing? I don't fucking know. Fuck it. I'm not questioning. I love this game, but I don't fucking like that part. Why do you have to do this?
And I'll open my nose up real wide and sniff real hard.
It made sense in the anime because they got a thing that belonged to Kanji. He sniffed it and he got his scent. That made more sense, but this! Just because you know something? I don't fucking know.
Oh, I think I found something. It feels like our target. Is this it?
Maybe.
Follow me!
Okay.
I hear you ringing on my heart.
Now, as I said before, you guys said it's all good to skip the dungeon stuff. You know, the boring shit. We'll probably do 2 floors and then, you know, I'll just skip the rest. Unless something cool happens. It's awfully muggy.
Is it just me, or does the fog here seem kind of different?
Yeah.
My glasses are fogging up.
Oh boy.
Man, it's hot in here. This place is like a...
Santa. Sauna. Pana.
Come here, pussycat.
Oh no.
Oh, such well-defined pecs.
Oh no.
There's no need to be scared.
That's all the reason to be scared. I vote we go have steak.
Now just relax.
I don't think I can.
Wait a sec. I don't want
to
go.
I said it first, so therefore you have to go.
Is Kanji-kun really here, Teddy?
Honestly, Teddy, can't he be in a park?
The nose knows!
We're really going in here? I can already feel the sweat rolling down my back.
Oh boy.
That's because it's so hot.
Yeah. Oh, Jesus. Kaji's location has been pinpointed. All that's left is to rescue him. You should prepare yourself for a rescue mission. I got you. I know just the way to prepare. Just give me a second. We're ready.
This place is really steamy. So why don't I feel a chill down my spine? I think I got a cold. My nose is totally useless too. Kanji-kun, where are you? Answer us!
Oh boy, this is the squad right here. Jesus Christ. Let's go. Oh fuck, I missed. Don't fucking hit me. Oh no. Enemy advantage. Stand by.
Well,
fuck you. And fuck you. Fuck you.
That was easy.
Oh boy. Okay, and another question about Persona 3. Do you want me to start from scratch, or do you want me to just do, do a new game plus with my clear data so we can just fly through and get the story out of the way like we're doing this? Just let me know what you think in the comments below, because honestly, Persona 3 is going to be a lot more difficult because I can't fucking control my partners, so they act like complete dumbasses in battle at times. What about the boss? Enemy shadows!
Now's our good answer!
Fuck them off! Boom! We did it! Yay! Now, give me my honey, even though I'm loaded. Now. Okay, let's see. Well, actually, maybe I'll just put in the whole dungeon and that'll just end the episode. Because, I mean, I'm not sure how many floors this dungeon has, but I don't think it's that long. Now, if we were doing any of the other ones, couple I could think of, those are long, so those would have to be split up. But yeah, this will probably be the last one I'll add in all the dungeon. You guys can let me know if you... Oh, no, stop that. You guys can let me know if... Wait, it's a weakness. So yeah, hey, he doesn't do that.
Charge through him!
Bagrai.
It's over. So persistent.
Yukiko. I got this.
Persona!
Maguridain! Yeet, I did it.
Victory!
Yay. I did it. I'm amazing. Now, open the door. And this was just a dead end. Hop off! Player advantage! Fuck them up!
Biff! Two enemies! You can attack before them!
Biff! Yes, you did. Good job. Now that we have four people in our party, the experience is gonna be even less! Oh god, a shadow jumped out! Gold handless? No. Well, fuck you too, game.
I smell three make answers! Don't get careless!
Fuck you! Oof! Whatever! Yes, we won. Let's go! I don't think I have any personas with victory. Alright, that sucks. So I gotta kinda be careful with my mana. I literally forgot that, you know, that shit runs out. But yeah, so this is basically done. Oh god, I just remembered Persona 3's dungeons. Oh Jesus Christ, those are horrid. Oh god, that's horrid. That's gonna be. Whoa! Oh boy! I'm gonna have to skip those because, oh Jesus, it's just horrid.
A rare monster.
Hang it on!
Stuffing out of
but yeah, with Persona 3, just let me know in the comments if you want me to do new game plus so I just have some strong ass gear and can automatically just plow through dungeons and shit. Because,
not
oh boy.
Bad,
I leveled up.
Level
you leveled
me.
Up. You learned Glaudo. Does medium wind damage to one foe. Well, we're gonna replace that. Growl.
I leveled up.
You learn Gale Slash. What does it do? Light fist damage to all foes. Light fist damage to one foe. My favorite weapon to one foe is chance of pad deck. Well, just get rid of assault. There you go.
Has it gotten a little stronger?
Yes, you have. You got recon. And then we move on. But yeah, Persona 3's dungeons. Oh boy, those are bad. Because it's just really, really long.
We haven't come across this Kanji-kun yet. Oh yeah, Sensei, can I ask you something? Why is it so steamy in here? Does it have something to do with Kanji-kun? I don't really get it. Do you know what it is, Sensei?
I think I can hint.
That's my Sensei. Is there anything you don't know?
I don't know why. No, I actually know everything, Teddy. Thanks for noticing. No! You're not getting away from me, you little shit! I need that experience! I'm gonna run out of mana. I don't think that's overkill.
We won!
Yes, we did.
You did it, Sensei!
I leveled up again! My bird leveled up. Yoshi leveled up. Yeah, leveled up. Yogeko leveled up. Okay. That's cool. And then we open the chest. And a shadow jump up. Another golden hand, please? No. It's a muscle guy. So, fuck you. Fuck you. And fuck up. Oh, gee, god damn it. Fuck you. There we go.
I'm on a roll today.
Yay. Baby experience is the worst experience. One snuff soul. Well, let's go. Let's see. Oh, the shadow! Fire advantage! I'm dead. You don't have headphones on, Yosuke, stop! Anyways. Da-ba-da-ba-da, we did it. Let's move on, shall we? He's a shadow. I missed! Ugh! That angle, though. I die. And we did it. It's shuffle time. Let's get a skill card. Skill card! Dodge electricity, huh? Well, I think I'm impervious to it because Izanagi's element is electricity, but I don't fucking remember, to be honest. Let's open chest. What do we get? A snuff soul. I could probably actually use some of that. Let me just... Oh, God, that's only 10. Yeah, that works. Thanks. Appreciate it. Anyways, let's go! Oh god, clip the quarter. The door, let's go! That's another muscle man, kill it!
Here's your chance!
Good job, you didn't miss this time, Chie. And what do we got for our shovel time? We got a Persona 07. I don't want a Persona, just give me the money. Wow. And we move on. Boo, 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 boo. Is this the stairs? No, it's a split. I shall go left. Oh, to go to chess, I don't need that. Anyways, I should have gone right. Right is always the right way. Anyways. And there's the door leading to victory. Yes, it is, but let's check what's behind door number two first. It's a shadow. Die, shadow. It's called me being lazy. Fuck this. Those guys, they know they don't do good to physical attacks. Oh, fuck it. Shuffle time. Let's see. Just give me that HP SP recovery. Thank you. Probably gonna do HP even though I don't fucking need it. I can't tell. But most likely it did. It's another shadow. Oh, my boo! Bitch! We can do this! Fuck them up! Yeah, we did it. Oh, we are in a Santa, so that's understandable, Yukiko. Shit! Oh, it's another fucking golden chest. Damn it. Well, anyways, let's move to the next floor.
Whoa! I just got goosebumps! Something is on this floor, be careful!
Oh boy, that's... cool.
Shadow! Guy!
Never to say what's taking so long. Let's fuck him up! Fuck him up! Fuck him up! Yeah, good job, Jay. You did it. Oh boy. Moving ahead. Let's see what's onward. We must go to victory. Open the door.
Oh, this presence! Could it be Kanji-kun?
Open the door and enter. Yes, I think so. We got our uniforms back. Why does he stand like that? It's stands like fucking Wario.
Kanji!
Dumb boy.
Oh, my, my. Thank you for your undivided attention. At last, I've penetrated the facility.
No.
These images are coming to you live from inside this steamy paradise.
Please don't.
But I've yet to have any charming encounters. Could this hot fog be the cause? It's like steam rising from sweat. My body's tingling with excitement.
Oh god. Manon, Kachi, Tatsumi, and Rosie Steamy Paradise.
This is so wrong in so many ways.
I'm with you, my boy. Can we please just go get steak now?
I remember it being kinda like this on Yukiko's show, too. No, it wasn't like this.
Oh, you embarrassed because your other self was acting like a body.
Those voices again. Wait, are they louder this time?
Maybe.
These voices. I was wondering whose they could be since it's only the victim in here. Is it the people watching outside?
Maybe. So can they see you?
You mean everybody who's watching the Midnight Channel? They're reacting to the show? Yikes! If people are watching Kanji-kun now, he's gonna be a legend in a way he never intended.
Yerp.
Well, it's really his shadow, not him. But normal people won't know that.
Yeah. His shadows are...
The shadows are getting really restless.
Too much.
That elusive thing I truly yearn for. Will I finally find it here?
I don't fucking know, man.
Well then, onward and deeper to reach further realms of romance. Let's get going, dammit!
Oh god. Freaky alien genotype.
Kanji-kun!
Oh, that was his other self. It's trying to reveal his hidden feelings.
He wants sausage.
It seems much worse than that time with Yuki-chan's shadow.
Yeah.
At this rate, it might end up getting bare naked.
Bare naked?
Oh, man, here it comes.
Was I supposed to laugh?
Get played, son. You failed! Damn. Oh, Lord in heaven.
Oofy.
Fuck you. Oh boy, death!
Oh, a shadow!
A golden hand, perhaps? A fucking Gorsmod! I could have pressed square.
Yo, baby!
Please experience.
Yes! Oh, baby! 17K!
What, darling?
Yay, baby!
A bad monster! Beat the stuffing out of it!
Persona!
Well, now that that's out of the way, time for the story points.
Where on the 4-4? You hear voices from somewhere.
A man can't back down in a time like this. Just watch, I'll show you how manly Kanji Tatsumi can be! A man's got this thing called pride. I'll never lose.
It's no good.
It seems getting worse, so I can't tell where Kanji-kun is at all. Maybe it's already time for me to retire from being a guide.
Yeah, you're not really a good one.
This feeling, the other Kanji is staring at us.
The other Kanji is staring at us.
Hey there, cutie pie. Are you trying to break the barrier of acceptance just like me?
No, Sensei came to rescue Kanji.
Oh, does this mean you're yearning for me? Is that so? Oh, that makes me so happy. Well, then I must simply I simply must prepare something spectacular for you. I'm looking forward to seeing you soon. Well, toodaloo!
Yeah, basically my whole thought to that.
Sensei, this little bear's getting too scared to go on.
I was scared to start.
Yeah. For some reason, this floor is really steamy. Hang in there, guys.
I'll try my best, man, but
Really uncomfortable with what's going on. I feel like Kaji's gonna sneak out of nowhere and take off my towel, try to touch my foot in long chong. And I know it's admirable, but Kaji, no men allowed, please. Masasu is drifting in from the other side of the door. Open the door and answer hell yes. Let's do this.
Welcome to a man's world. This place is heating up from the sudden entry of a fine young man. To celebrate this encounter, I prepared a special stage tonight. A single match with no time limit. Who will be left standing in the end? Now pour out your hot blood and guts. Oh, don't lose, Sensei!
I can't make any promises, Teddy. Things aren't looking very good.
One enemy ambushed you! Hang in there!
Good night. Well, fuck you. I'm just kidding. Boom! Okay, that didn't do much. Let's do this. You do it too, yo. Okay, copy. Light dab, light dab. Fuck it out. It's boofle.
I'm boofle!
Dude, fucking hell. What about attacks? How does that do? It's about the same. Critical rate up. That's not good. Fuck him up. Just fuck him up.
She leveled up! She leveled up!
Anyways.
That's our sensei! I knew you would win!
You obtained Bathhouse Key. Oh, baby.
No. No, damn it. That ain't important to a man's man. That's not what I want to become. That ain't it at all!
What?
Hey, sensei. The world you came from seems really complicated. Ever since I met you, I really had to think about stuff like, what am I? So I can kind of understand how Kanji feels. Sensei, we gotta save Kanji.
I guess. I mean, I wanted to get steak, but, you know, things come up, I guess. Fuck you, Shadow. I don't need you. Wasted everyone's time enough. Let's just go and fight Kanji and get the fuck out of here. No, it's still more floor.
This place is great. It's wonderful here. Something definitely feels wrong. Sensei, we need to hurry.
Yeah, I guess. I mean, we could just walk. Are we finally there? God damn it!
I can't hear Kanji's voice. Alrighty. I'm gonna get myself pumped up again to look for Kanji. Concentrate. Roar! Here goes. Whoa, this feeling. I think I've made a comeback. Kanji's not far from here. I'm positive he's really close by.
Okay. So that means next floor. Hopefully. It's Jesus Christ. You've been gone for a while, man. It's almost reaching 2 hours. I'm gonna have to cut this dungeon. I thought the dungeon would be like probably a half an hour, maybe just like 20 minutes, but no. It shit took a long fucking time. Boo! Die, you little bitches!
Get over here! Give me that butt!
There we go. Yay! We made it! Now, let's use a go home. And then return to the entrance. Oh, yes. Sensei sure knows some neat people. Nice to meet you, Mr. Fox. Let's both do our best. As for healing. Hey. As for you, Let's go, Teddy. And then we just go.
I sense Kanji. He must be behind this door. Open the door.
Yes. Donuts. We're here to save you, Kanji.
Kanji!
Oh, come now. Enough with the charade. Isn't it awful to deceive people? To deceive yourself? What's so bad about doing what I want to do?
And
that has nothing to do with it. I'm what you really want, aren't I? Hell no! Oh, how I hate girls. So arrogant and self-centered. They cry if you get angry, they gossip behind your back, they spread nasty lies.
Well, other than the crying part, guys do the same shit.
They look at me like some disgusting thing and say that I'm a weirdo.
Well, I mean, look at you.
Looking at me all the while. You like to sew? What a queer. Painting is so not you.
I mean, how can you rip off someone for painting? If you hate on someone for painting, then you're just a fuck.
But you're a guy. You don't act like a guy. Why aren't you manly? What does it mean to be a guy? What does it mean to be manly?
It means fucking bitches and smoking weed and drinking beer, I think. I don't know. I learned from the internet.
That's so scary.
I don't agree with you. They have these things called boobs. They're basic.
I'm scared of them!
I mean, technically a guy could have them too, but that's not attractive.
Men are much better.
Oh, I disagree.
I never say those awful, degrading things. Yes, I vastly prefer men.
Whatever floats your boat, man. Just don't touch my foot long shlong.
What makes you think you can say that shit with my face?
When his voice gets lighter, it's just...
Why, you're me. And I'm you. You do know that, don't you?
His face looked like he just nutted. Like, Jesus Christ, man.
No. Nuh-uh. No way! There's no way in hell that you're me!
Yeah, he's you.
You're me, and there's no denying it!
Oh boy. Look what you did. Look at that monstrosity.
Kanji-kun!
Everyone, on guard!
Let's do this shit! Oh boy! Mickey Mouse is gonna fuck some shit up!
I don't know what the fuck that was.
The true self.
Yeah.
I'm just being true to myself. And that's why I'll get rid of anything in my way.
Are these Kanji-kun's true feelings?
Maybe.
This isn't really him. It's just his emotions going haywire.
This has nothing to do with you guys anymore. Didn't I just say I'm gonna get rid of you?
Did you? I don't know. Well, you know, I don't listen to weirdos. I'm just gonna use debilitate on you. We're gonna use blah 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 on all of you. And then we're gonna use Bubble Fool on all of you. I think one of you is weak to it, so that's good. Yeah.
That's my cue. Leave it to me.
Fuck him up, Yosuke! Good job, Yosuke. Use Aki on that motherfucker. Boosh.
Not bad, Yukiko!
And then use. Do it again. I don't fucking know, man. I was trying to think of something smart to do, but I couldn't think of anything. What did you do? We got infected with poison. Oh, Jesus. Red wall. Well, he's already kind of fucked up. Yeah.
Sensei, hurry and get rid of that poison!
No. I think I'll just go through the pain, you know what I'm saying, Teddy?
Yosuke's all poisoned!
Don't know if I have anything that does that. Same amount, okay, it's all ailments, okay, here. There we go. Now we're fine. Jay, use, Boofu on that motherfucker. Do it, Tamoe! Blah, boof! Do it again! Blah, blah, boof! And then, what's the thing? Oh, there we go. There we go. Oh no, Yosuke, you're gonna get fucked up. Yep.
Don't give up, Yosuke!
Wait. Oh, you fucker. Repatra? Oh, you motherfucker! Chia ate that shit, bitch. Anyways, I think we've fucked around enough. Izanagi, come fuck these motherfuckers up. Kill them! Explode! Yep.
You're gonna pay, damn it!
Explode! Let's see, do we have any? I think we got some firecrackers, actually. Yeah. So, fuck you. Oh, I thought I did the red wall thing, I guess. Not. Oh, well.
Come on!
Boom! Ba-da-boom! Wow. That's not what I... thought I fire broke you. Oh, well, I guess not. I don't know. Fuck it.
Get out of my way!
No!
Or I'll crush you!
Sorry, we have to kill you, man.
Come with me!
Never mind. That's just nasty.
Yosuke's all poisoned!
The only person I'm coming with is you, Kiko! Damn it. I thought that would work. Magarala!
Yosuke's all poisoned!
Rampage! Boom! I didn't do much. Morgrion!
I know you all thought it was weird. Down. You don't accept me at all.
We didn't even know you.
No matter what, I won't lose.
I think you will. Attack averted, invasion averted, defense averted. Frantic spark. Yosuke's gonna get hit. God damn it, Yosuke. Revolution!
Wow,
critical rate way up. Fire resistance reverted. Hey, Yosuke's gonna get fucked up. Oh, no, not much.
Sensei, hurry and get rid of that poison!
No! I'm ending it! My one! Dead. Oh, he's not dead.
Damn it!
Yosuke, it's your time to shine! Fuck him up!
Poisoned.
Good job! And he dead. Bitch. We got 3,000 experience. Die, bitch. We did it.
Damn it.
Kanji-kun.
Wait, Yukiko. Something's wrong.
Motherfucker got back up. Oh no!
It's still coming at us. Kanji is still rejecting it.
Yeah.
Well, I can't blame him with this many witnesses.
Exactly.
Such a passionate approach.
Are you sure about that?
What?
I think that you three would make wonderful boyfriends.
Sutton, no. Yosuke's the feminine one. Take him. I need the poos.
Stop it. You got it all wrong.
Yeah, I'm hitting the girl behind me. Yukiko, that poos is mine. I don't want sausage, man.
Enough. Stop. What the hell are you blabbering about?
I don't care who, won't someone
Anyone please accept me?
I want a face like that.
Stop it! Accept me for who I am!
I don't know. Seems like a hassle.
I really don't swing that way!
Yeah, man, I like I said, I need poos. I don't want boy poos. I need female poos. Knocked the shit out of him.
Can't believe something like this is inside me.
Kanji, you're...
Yeah, I know. I've known all this time I had something like you.
So you like butt stuff?
It ain't a matter of guys or chicks. I'm just scared shitless of being rejected. I'm a total pansy who tries to make everyone hate me.
You're not alone, you puss.
Come on, get up. Anyone who looks like me, I know they ain't so weak that they can't take a punch. I already know that you're me. You're me. And I'm you, damn it.
Yeah, damn it. Now you get a persona. Beefy as fuck. Kanji has faced his other self. He has obtained the facade used to overcome life's hardships, the persona Takemikazuchi.
Shit.
Kanji-kun!
Let's get him out of here.
Yeah, or he's gonna die. Are you gonna ask how does his jacket stay on his shoulders? But he fell, that should have really made
Kanji-kun,
him fall off.
Are you okay?
No, he's dead. We have to arrange the funeral. You have to tell his mom that Yosuke did it. You know, Yosuke always takes the fall, right, Yosuke?
It's nothing. Whoa. I feel great. It's like my mind's all cleared up.
Glad to hear it. I guess.
Hey, about what just happened.
Yeah. It's a dream. Forget about it. We'll tell you later, son. I don't want to relive that.
You better.
Or what? I'm gonna skip town and never come back.
You need to take a rest now.
Yeah.
We'll be waiting for you at school.
Yep.
School? Sure, if I ever feel like going.
You're a horrible kid, John. Go to fucking school.
I'll take this guy home.
Yeah.
If anyone asks, I'll just say I found him somewhere like this.
Okay, good for you. So he won't try butt stuff with me. He can try it with you, Yosuke. Thanks for taking one for the team. You were able to rescue Kanji. Now you must wait for him to recover. Will this take you one step closer to solving the case? Maybe. And it's after school and it's evening. And we're having dinner. The three of you are sitting down and having dinner.
Oh, I forgot to tell you.
What?
Remember that Kanji Tatsumi guy I told you about?
Yeah.
You know, the one who went nuts on that news special.
Yes.
His family's shop called in to report him missing. But now he's been found.
Okay.
I thought I'd let you know since you go to the same high school.
Okay. Sure, whatever. I didn't know about that.
Well, I doubt there would have been too much fuss about a guy like him disappearing.
Yeah.
One other thing.
Yes.
Some people have seen you around that textile shop lately, I hear. It's not the kind of shop students normally visit.
Oh, shit.
Just what kind of business did you have there?
A friend took me there.
A friend?
Yes, Yukiko.
Oh, that Amagi girl.
Yes.
That's right. Her family's inn buys their stuff wholesale. Fine. Just don't get yourself in over your head, okay?
I'm not doing anything. You're acting like I'm dealing coke.
Are you fighting again?
No, he's pecking on me. Oh, Lord. Yes, I would like to say, because Jesus, we need to stop. It's been 2 hours, almost 2.5 hours since I've been playing this fucking game. I gotta cut that dungeon down to a lot, but anyways, I hope you all are enjoying Persona 4 Golden still. I know it's been a while since we've been on it, but
Like I said, I just wanted to get Sunrider up to current events, so, you know, I'm in current time with it like everything else, but, like I said earlier in the video, if you guys, I'm gonna be playing Persona 3 eventually, but I just wanna know if you wanna wait till after Persona 4 or during Persona 4, we play them both at the same time. It's up to you guys, it's all good, and if you want me to use New Game Plus so we don't have to fucking deal with the dungeon shit or use, fucking, what do you call it, just do an old game, and stuff. Anyways, hope you all are still enjoying, and if you are, hit the thumbs up button, save your favorites, share it with your friends! This has been Conixis. You can follow me on Twitter, link is in the description below. Thank you all for watching, I love you all, and I'll see you all in the next one. Goodbye, everyone. I spurt of blood erupted from the race nose. Oh my lord. Her eyes rolled back into her skull and she fell back. Her soul emerged from her body and flew up to heaven.
Compact, they killed my sister! We're going to pay for this. Montana!